Hi, this is James Cook with the University of Maine at Augusta, and I'm here in the Maine woods. Why? To do a little bit of social research through extension. The neat thing about research is that once you learn the mechanics of it, you can apply it to just about any topic. And one difficult thing about studying people is that they tend to move around. So for today's lesson, we're going to look at something that stays put, trees. When we do research, we think about units of analysis. That is, what we want to understand, and certain variables about those units of analysis, things we can observe about our units of analysis, characteristics that vary. That's what variables are. Now, I come into the woods today with a hypothesis. A hypothesis is a prediction about how two variables regarding a unit of analysis relate to one another. There's an independent variable and a dependent variable. The dependent variable is the outcome you're interested in. For instance, I want to understand the dependent variable of how many other trees are within 3 feet of a single tree. That's my dependent variable. It's a characteristic of a tree. How many other trees are within 3 feet of it? But I want to be able to try to predict that. What would predict that? And I have an idea. It's a prediction. And my prediction is that an independent variable, which is the diameter of the tree's trunk, will be negatively related to my dependent variable, the number of trees around it. To say I have a negative relationship means that as one goes up, the other goes down. So I, in other words, am predicting that as the diameter of a tree trunk goes up, gets bigger, there will be fewer trees within 3 feet of it. Now, I need to have a theory to support that. My theory is that trees, as they get bigger, develop more leaves, a bigger canopy, which starves out other trees that would grow around it, thereby clearing the area of nearby younger trees. That's my theory. And it generates a hypothesis regarding an independent variable, diameter, and its effect on a dependent variable, number of trees within 3 feet. Now, that's all lovely theory. That's a great hypothesis, but the point in research is to measure. I'm going to make a measurement. And every variable you create, whether it's in tree research or social research regarding people, should be measurable. If you can't measure it, there's no point in doing research, right? So I'm going to measure the diameter, and then I'm also going to measure a nice 3 foot range, and I'm going to count the number of trees. I'm going to write down my information, and then I'm going to show you what that information looks like. Ready? Let's get started. All right, I'm back. I've taken a look at 10 trees. They're in my data set. Obviously, if I really wanted to study the forest in depth, I would look at, well, a lot more than that. But for those 10, those are 10 observations, also known as 10 cases. You'll notice I have 3 variables. The tree number, I just gave each tree a number, its diameter in inches, and you may not be able to read my chicken scratch, the number of trees within 3 feet. So then I have rows. Every case, every observation has its own row, and it has its own value for the variable. This is tree number 3. It's 3 inches in diameter, and it has just one other tree within 3 feet of it. The whole set of all my data is called a data set. I've just gathered a data set, And while it may not look too useful on paper, when we take it back home and we put it in something called a spreadsheet, we will have variables that we can then analyze to see, at least for this set of 10 trees, we can see whether my prediction, my hypothesis, turns out to be supported or not. That's how research works with trees, and that's how research works with people too. The only difference is you kind of have to follow people around as they move, and they're a little harder to observe.